Hey everybody, I'm Blitz. Welcome to a brand new series on a game called Valley. So Valley is a first-person adventure game. I guess that's the best way to put it. It's got a lot of storyline in it as well. I know a lot of you guys are like, oh, I can't believe you're playing a storyline game. This is so boring. Now just hold on. Every once in a while, I like to put a story game on the channel. We've done things like Soulless Project. We've done things like Firewatch and some other really good games in there too. So I've been really looking forward to this game and I really want to share it with you guys. With that said, this is developed by a company called Blue Isle Studios, who made a game called Slender, The Arrival. Now, this isn't a horror game, but it is probably going to be a pretty good story, because based on that other game, it had really good reviews. I didn't play it, but it had really good reviews on Steam, and this one's starting to pick up some good reviews too, so we're going to see how it goes. I also want to say that this first video is sponsored, but the rest of the series is not, so I'm going to be playing through it. I'm actually going to sit down this weekend and play through the entire thing, and so you guys don't spoil what's going to happen, because I know some of you guys really like to spoil things, and it's not cool. It's not cool at all. So I'm going to play through it and then share it with you guys over the next couple weeks, if that makes any sense. It's supposed to be like 3 to 6 hours long, so anywhere between 6 to 12 videos. And I guess I'm just going to get in it. If you want any more information, you can read it down below in the video description. There will be spoilers probably down in there, because I'm going to copy the Steam description like I always do. And there's the links that you can go get the game. I believe it'll be on all of the major consoles eventually, as Slender was. So, let's get going. I'm going to make a brand new game. I've tested out the settings a little bit. The sensitivity is quite high to begin with, so I've been messing with it. I've also dialed my mouse back a little bit, so we've got a new settings on that. Hopefully it won't be jarring. The life seed is said to contain an incredible earth-shattering power. While mostly written off as a myth, some archaeologists are still determined to track down the elusive item, luring some to incredibly remote locations.
Hey, looks like I missed you. I just wanted to wish you luck before you headed out. I still can't believe you're doing this. I mean, hunting down the... what was it? The life seed? You gotta admit, that sounds crazy. I mean, even if this mythological thing that can shatter worlds or whatever actually exists, what are the chances of you tracking down this ancient relic in the middle of the Rocky Mountains? Listen, I know you want to prove the thing exists. I get that. It's an adventure. Well, it's your career, but can't you do something normal like the rest of us and just backpack Europe or something? Spend a month in Thailand? But hey, if by some miracle you find this thing and become the most famous archaeologist of all time, beers are on me. I'll even trade in your tinfoil hat for a whip and fedora. I just really hope all those canoeing lessons pay off.
So you get a little bit of a background. We're going to be searching for the life seed, and we're going to go into the Canadian Rockies, and hopefully we find something. We've been taking canoeing lessons, and evidently the canoeing lessons didn't really pay off. Hey, yep, there's the canoe on the left. Great. Go us. Congratulations, you derp-a-derp. Way to drive this boat. Okay, we're coming to. Sounds like a radio. Yep, remote region, Canadian Rockies. There's some junk down here. Useless discount canoeing lessons. I guess that's our thoughts with that going up there. And evidently our radio is smoking, so that's not good. There's nothing to collect here, and this is literally as far as I've gone. So let's get on and... wow. Look at that water. That's fantastic. We're going to run through, I guess. Ooh, what is that thing? Runes? Cave drawings? Look at that. Okay, that's a little creepy. Where am I? Yeah, that's kind of creepy. Maybe it is going to be a creepy game. I'm not... oh, hold shift to run. I've been doing that already. Look at that water. I love it. I'm a water nerd. I like water and the reflections in games. Oh, look at this thing. So that's another weirdo... alien drawing thing. Okay. Come on in. Get into some light now. Oh, cool. Whoa, look at that grass. And the flowers. Is it... no, it's not. Sometimes it's like 1 2D. Well, it is 2D, but sometimes it follows you and it always looks at you, making it look 3D in a way. So these are just flat. Sounds cool. I hear some animals rustling or something. Flowers running everywhere. Nice. Okay, we're coming up to anything special? Maybe? Look at the trees. Okay. Alright. Or is birds? It's back here. This better not be a collectible game. I don't think it is. Like, go collect flags like Assassin's Creed. No, thank you. Oh, there we go. Valley. I guess we're in the valley now. Ooh. What's in here? That's pretty. Okay, these are really neat. Look at this thing. Can I touch it? Oh, they're so shiny. Oh, new music too. Looks like some pillars were broken. Oh, I like it. Reminds me of Avatar a little. Got some old pots here, looks like. What are those things? Creepy statue. Yeah, run into the area where there's like ghosty stuff. That's a good idea. Oh, kaboomski. No thanks. Hey, little fella. Hey, ho, 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 whoa. Okay, let's keep moving. What is this place? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking right now. They're squeaking. How hard did I hit my head? Must have been pretty hard. Ate some funny mushrooms or something. What's in there? I hope there aren't little side areas to go, because I don't plan on exploring many of them. But I hope it's not entirely linear either, if that makes sense. A lot of times story games are. Ooh. Okay, we got some wheels and looks like some film. Is that film? Yeah. An old army truck. Huh. Must have crashed here ages ago. Ooh. What is this? This must be the thing I... Yep, leaf suit. So this is what I read about on the Steam forums and what's been said in the trailers. I'm going into this completely blind, if you don't know. I've been saving myself for it. Okay, that sounds pretty cool. Cool, leaf suit, yeah, I guess. Oh, wow, oh, I guess we have it on. We have some energy bar. Ooh. That's kind of cool. Let's see what's on these old audio reels. Okay.
Virginia King, Audio Journal, June 4th, 1941. Shortly after the outbreak of war in Europe, I was enlisted by the army to study the history of this valley. The mysterious forest sprites seem to be the last living remnants of the long-lost culture that once lived here. A large number of them seem to inhabit the northeast sector of the valley, just past the ruins where the life seed, rumored to possess an earth-shattering power, was found. That's as good a place as any to study them.
Okay. That's kind of neat. Search for the life seed near the dig site. I hope... Oh, we have knees. What is this? The mushroomy shrooms? Okay, that's where we're going. What's this say? Archaeological excavation site. Dig site located... northeast on trail. Okay. Yeah! Run down slopes to gain momentum and jump further. Oh, yes please. Oh, wow. Okay, and... Oh, dirty! That was cool. Alright.
This is gonna be fun now.
And gain speed. Yes, there he goes. Okay, come on. Jump down, run down the hill. And we can clear. Oh, we're flying now. Hooah! Oh, we're. Oh, we need to go this way.
Oh, the music's cool. I love it. Oh, we're flying and stuff. We can kind of change momentum and trajectory in the air.
Oh, not gonna have enough juice. Ah, maybe I will. Yeah. Whee.
I'm waiting for like a deer to jump out or something. Oh, there's a tree. Watch out. Do we have... Okay, I think we're okay. Whoa, there's a bridge. Made it. Yeah, they keep scaring me and thinking they're a deer. Okay, now come around the corner. And nothing. Oh, there is something. Energy stored in leaf suit known as Amrita can be given to once living things. Okay. Shoot energy towards trees or dead animals. Oh no! There's a dead critter! There are deer here. Hey buddy! Hey buddy! Ho ho! Whoa! That's a nice one. Wouldn't mind having you in my wall. My freezer. I'm back here. Don't go in the water, you ding dong. Well, whatever. There'll be more of you. Aha. Oop. Hey, where am I going? Do I need to follow that deer? I don't know where he went. Oh, I need to jump. Oh, jump on the rocks. Got this. We can do it. What's this say? Leaf suits must be worn. There's the deer again. All right. Wah. Uh-oh. Oh, stay down. Good job. Wah. Got it again. Very nice. There's the little spirit orbs. Touch an orb to gain energy. Yeah. Ah, that makes sense. That's what that thing in the past was. Ooh. Can I get more energy? Do we... Oh, what's going on? Wah! There it is, up. Good job. I want it. Can I shoot the tree? Ew. I guess that used up energy. Can I shoot you? Ew. Ha! That didn't do anything. Is there anything dead? I want to turn it to life again. Whee! I guess this is telling me where to go. Up. There it is. And... I have a feeling we're going to run out of these things, like, eventually. We won't have any more. Oh, we're going fast now! Mm-hmm. There's some deer. Oh no, buddy! Oh no! Oh, you're still alive. Life can be taken. Oh. Oh. Wait. Okay. Hi, bunny. No way! We just totally killed a rabbit. Here. Live. Live long and prosper, my bunny friend. That's kind of cool. Now I'm down a little heartbeat deal. Energy block. Battery. Got my bunny legs on. Energizer legs. Okay, what do we have up here? Excavation site. Restricted area. Authorized. There's a deer. Authorized access within this. This dude's a breach of security. Okay. Yep. Let's do a little bit of run. And we're going to do a little run up. And then we're going to fly. Ah, quest updated. Oh, there's a dead tree. We'll fix you, tree. Hey. Seems like these fireflies react to energy. Pew, pew. Oh, that tree did it. Never mind. I better collect these blue balls before we can do anything else. So we open this up. Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
The army calls this valley Area 634. But I've ascribed a new word for it. Susurrus. The beauty of that word seems to rival the majesty of this place. I suppose that would make its ancient inhabitants officially known as Susurrians. These ruins have existed here for so long. They predate any known civilization on the continent. They seem to have infused the life energy from trees into their infrastructure, but how?
Probably the life seed. That's my guess. Okay, we open up the door. Looks like it's going to be a little bit of a puzzler with opening things up. Why didn't the army come in here originally and open things? E to open crates. Oh. Scratch that. The army was in here at one point. What's this? Note from a Pathfinder. I could watch these sprites all day. I can't believe how friendly they are. Brave enough to come right up to us. I guess they have no reason to fear us. We aren't natural predators to them after all. Energy cap. Capacity is increased with capacitor upgrades. Find four to complete. Oh, okay. Aha. There's another. Oh. I'm guessing that's another couple in here. There we go. Get another energy deal. Yes, there's the third one. You just drop down. Oh, it's filled up already. Okay. Kaboomski! Kaboomski! Yeah, I got that one. What's this? Nothing. What do we have this way? Let's go check.
Luckily for me, the military is helping to explore all these ruins through the soldiers piloting L.E.A.F suits. They call these soldiers Pathfinders, so they can trek through terrain normally inaccessible to someone like me. Every guy back home's gonna want to go joyriding in a L.E.A.F suit. But until the military's project comes to a close, we're cut off from any contact outside the valley. I guess the world will have to wait just a bit longer to get their hands on these rides.
It's kind of interesting. What do we have down here? Oh! Use falling momentum to break through cracked surfaces. Okay, what about breaking through exploring surfaces? Like, I want to explore things? Oh yeah! Look at this. See, exploration pays off sometimes. Get some more pendulum going on. What is this? Medallion? These medallions are said to use access to ancient pyramid. Collect enough pieces to gain entry to its chambers. Collect enough acorns to gain access through certain ancient doorways. Alright. Acorn and beakorn. So we have two, we have three and one. That sounds good to me. Looks like we have to run back around. And then I guess we just fall through. That wasn't so bad. Ooh. Run, run. Oh, loading screen. Soldiers piloting L.E.A.F suits leap effortlessly through air functionality are known as Pathfinders. Their ability to manipulate life with running speeds up to 110 kilometers per hour makes them a deadly addition to the battlefield. Except bullets can travel faster than that. Okay, continue search for life seed. We can do that. And that's our whole goal here. More things down here. So that was broken through. Are we going to continue finding more upgrades?
What are these glowing orbs that everyone is making a fuss over? They're absolutely beautiful. They seem to grow randomly throughout the valley. I know nothing about them other than that they are indigenous to this valley and that the army is using their energy for their war project. That's about as much as they'll tell me. It's such a shame. I wish they would just let them be. But I suppose it's the whole reason we're here to begin with.
Wow. That's gorgeous. There's something blue. What can I zap? Susurrus Valley. Oh, can I take life out of this? Nope, I don't know what that was about. Neat. I'm gonna miss so much stuff, I know it. Like, exploring and finding every nook and cranny. There's a lot of stuff here. Aha, see, like this. Most people would have just ran past it. Medallion. Get a little orby orb. Okay, nothing in there. Let's keep rolling. What do we have? Oh, look at these other little sprites again. I got a bird flying by. Hey, little dudes. How are you? Nothing up here. Some deer. I guess if we really need energy, we can zap it from the deer. Oh dear, not going down there. Uh oh, I think the bridge has fallen. I am going down there. Valley health. So what happens when you die? You just kind of recharge. This quantum death functionality allows the user to return to life after dying. Oh, it's like tutorial telling me I died. And how to get back up. Oh, and then the energy. Aha. Oh no, dear. But life must be traded for life. The more you die, the more valley will die around you until it's fully deadened. Without enough life in the valley, you cannot be revived. Oh no. Return to life, my friendly dear thing. Give life back to revitalize the valley. Okay. So we killed some things. We need to unkill them. I don't know where they're at, though. Now we gotta play Rescue Bambi. Bambi! Oh, there's trees. Okay, we can res the trees. That'll do it. Oh yeah, there's another tree. Oh, it's a good one. That's kind of cool. Oh, we're back up. And a golden acorn. Hey, acorn. Oh, you just run over it to pick it up. Nice. Okay, so we need to go this way? Do we need to go this way? Nope, we're not going that way. Continue running. Oh, more goodie boxes? What's this say? Excavation site. Authorized personnel only. That's us. We're authorized.
It's clear to me that the natives of the valley worshipped the giant tree here almost as a deity. Great lengths were taken to construct obelisks around this tree, which the ancients used to help grow it. I've begun to use the term Titan tree to designate this species. According to my interpretations, once every 1,000 years, the Titan tree will produce the mythological and famed life seed, said to possess the power to shatter the world into fragments. No wonder the military is so interested in this place.
Hmm. So we need to get a life seed out of that. What's this say? Note from a Pathfinder, those acorn doors are pretty neat. Captain Hall ordered us to collect enough acorns to open all the passageways in Sector 3. I'm about halfway there. Living on a prayer. What does this one says? Note from Virginia King, sacred trees are common in mythologies around the world, typically acting as symbols of growth, decay, and resurrection. Some act as concepts, such as the world tree, forget how to pronounce that, of North mythology, which provided a map for composition, there we go, of the universe, acting like a link between heaven, earth, and the underworld. But more recently, in Christian belief, the tree of life represents the immaculate state of humanity before the exposure to original sin causing the fall. I gotta say that I'm dyslexic, so doing a lot of reading like this could be a little tough sometimes, so go easy on me. Don't call me a ding-dong because I can't read. Some of us have issues with it. Okay, so we need to find all the red things, I'm guessing. Was that acorn? Nope. That's around here. There's like the limbs go out. Is this where we came in at? I think so? Maybe not. Yeah, that's where we came in. So we need to follow these branches, the underground branches to the obelisks. Let's see where they go. Let's go after this far left one first. I hear something running, maybe. What's this? Kind of cool. There's some more energy over here. I'm going to try to grab one of those. So green is give energy to, blue is take energy. Alright. That must be an obelisk right there. Hello, bunny friend. How are you? So I'm going to... Should we whip over to that one first, or should we continue going for this one? Let's go for that obelisk. Ooh, that's kind of cool. That's really pretty. You know, back when I was a kid, gaming, I'd have no idea that stuff like this could even exist. Back playing on the NES and Atari, there's no thought in my mind. Even the music is better than anything I could understand or comprehend as a kid. Some more trees here that are down, it looks like. We're gonna try to zap them. Get him back up and alive. Come here. And ta-da. Some more energy. Does that do anything? Hi, dear. Oh, there's another obelisk. Okay, there's the third. So there's the three obelisks. Let us see. Ah. I'm guessing this is where we need to go. To the base of the obelisk. Need to crash through that wall. Let's go spit our blue stuff everywhere. We got a leaf suit, so we're just going to YOLO through this wall. It's flashing. There we go. Haboomski! Haha, I did it. Now, this is always the place that I think is going to have those military crates. Oops.
Common across mythologies, from the apocalypse to Ragnarok. However, it's unusual for the event to surround a particular object, especially one acquired by mortals.
Ho ho! Okay then. We've turned on the tree. Two remaining. Let's go for that one first. Oh, there's something else I can turn on. I got a little green indicator. There it was. Right over here. Ha! Okay. Oh boy! Please don't die on death. Yeah, don't die when falling is what I meant to say. Alright, let's go back over to the side. I thought we were pretty much over here, but I guess not. Looks like the valley is still healthy. Bunnies are healthy. Little green weird things. Oh, we need to crash through this door. By giving life to trees, there's a chance golden acorns will drop. Three acorns. Okay. Oh, boy. Nice. I'm guessing we had to do that.
The little sprites of this valley, which I've come to call daemons, are so lively. I've done my best to study their behaviors, but without a zoologist on site, I'm mostly coming up dry. They're completely harmless, so the army tends to ignore them as they go about their research. I wonder if the world would clamor to have these daemons as pets. I'm sure my mother could use one. Better than all those feral cats in her backyard, anyways.
Crazy cat lady. I wouldn't mind having one of those little sparky things, as long as they're harmless. Kind of weird to have, like, a little... Whoa! Just need to make sure we're not running off into our death or something. Okay, come back over here. Some more shrooms. Whoa! We need to jump. I love how the military's been everywhere, just jumping off pendulum stuff, but there's some more acorns. Okay. Note from Virginia King. My mother would tell me stories of daemons as ghostly and benevolent nature spirits. The name seems fitting. It will have to do for now until a zoologist can classify those forest spirits more appropriately. I think you just said that. What's over here? Nothing. Okay. Some more glowy blue mushrooms. And looks good. Around the corner, this is gonna be, yep. Okay, let's turn you on. Excellent. I wanna run on this thing. Quest updated. Whoa! Oh no. What's that? Oh, it's just a tree. Now, I really want to test falling damage. That looks pretty far. We're good. Alright, now we need to head over to that side. I'm going to keep my eye out for any more trees. So this looks kind of cool down here. That's where that last obelisk was. We can run down here, it looks like. It's a little beach area. There are a couple trees down here that are dead, too. Ah! An acorn. Awesome. I was hoping we'd get something like that. And I might be able to clear that. Ooh, what's this? Might be able to clear this jump. Or I don't know if we can fall in the water, if that does anything bad. I bet, yeah, there's a crate over there, so we can go on that side. Let's go ahead and run down this hill, and we're gonna head over, see what happens here. Okay, so this should be able to pick up enough speed. You go into burst mode. There we go, and get across. Nice. Open the crate. Ah, another one of them. Another couple of those. Good news. We got 3 energy upgrades. There's something up top there. What's back here? I'm in the water. Oh, wow. It's like Assassin's Creed, where you straight up die from falling into the drink. Well, let's pretend not to do that again, and actually not do it. There's something over there, though. We need to get across. Wonder if it's the way out. Like, are we meant to come this way? Let's try it one more time. I think I can turn right after this rock. Right off of this, and... I made it. Are you kidding me? Wow! We're having super duper legs. That's kind of punishing. Well, I guess the game doesn't want us to go that way. Alright, so we're gonna forget about that area. I've gone ahead and healed a bunch of stuff up. And there's still some more stuff that's dead. I don't know. Ooh, is there an acorn falling? I don't see one. There's still more things dead. I'm just gonna try to repair everything up as I continue going. Getting all the little blue orbs is going to be important, I feel, so we're going to just grab as many as we can. We're going to try to stay fully loaded. I went back to where we broke down that wall, and that is where I left it. I left a few there. So we can just grab a few, repair up all these things. I need to keep watching for acorns, too. Because there's a lot of things like... Oh, you're kidding. Like that. That, aren't happy anymore. After we took our derpa-derpa spill. Hi. Give me that. Acorn? Nope. There's another one. Acorn? Hey, there was an acorn. Here you go. Okay, let's try to get over to this thing now. It looks like a bit of a jumping puzzle, maybe? Do I need to go from that way? I might... we have to run out on that. So let's try... Let's try jumping across these. That wasn't so bad. There's another box. What you got for me, box? Another medallion. Still haven't really figured out the purpose of those yet. Okay.
The origin of this valley's inhabitants continues to elude me. They seem to have coexisted with the mysterious forest sprites. I find loose hints of Mesoamerican civilizations, such as the Olmec, with their renowned colossal headstone sculptures dating back to 900 BC. Strangely, though, the Olmec civilization was much younger and located no less than 5,000 kilometers away from here.
Pew! Should I open up the door? That's another energy box? Yes, it is. Okay, we can run that way, or there's a little bit of a mystery over here. I'm gonna go for this way. Let's try this out. You're just gonna creep in. Oh, we're full. Okay. Made it. Oh, no. Okay. Is this just another... I don't wanna die. I'm too young. Thank you. Made it. Okay, we don't need any more orbs. Let's go explore up here. Is this just another way to get across to that island? I think it might have been. Yep. And a way to get out, too. Oh, this is the only way to get out. I guess you could get in there, too. Okay, let's go back and open up the door and see what we've got. Little dudes. Tree just gave me 2 acorns. There's another couple dead trees over here, like this one. Another 2 acorns here. And then this one's dead too. Got 1. Very good. Okay, what do we have here? Oh, awesome. That's really fun. I hold the drop down. I guess it's probably gonna trigger another cutscene, isn't it? Yay! Oh yeah, falling through the junk. No falling damage.
This civilization take hold so far north. The land here isn't arable, yet the population that lived here was clearly sedentary in nature. This leads me to believe this place was used as a sacred ground. Are these monuments to the mythical cannibal giants of native lore? The Saiteka?
Mythical giants. Ooh, is that a big box? I like big boxes. Note from a Pathfinder. Just my luck. First day of training, I run into one of those Amatris swarms. They keep on warning us about in the briefing. The thing nearly killed me. Thank goodness I had enough energy to pacify the swarm. What on earth made them so aggressive? Leaf suit upgrade. Icarus boost. To get higher and further across, double jump. Ah! Oh, each boost costs one energy. That doesn't sound good. We're fine.
Andrew Fisher, lead physicist. Beginning Pathfinder testing on the Icarus boost upgrade. The secondary boost augmentation to the leaf suit should allow a Pathfinder to jump twice in sequence through the air, increasing the height and distance of their leap drastically. Report any defects to a commanding officer immediately.
That's cool. What's that light all about? I don't know. Another one? Note from Virginia King. While pyramids are coming through a Mesoamerica, I still couldn't believe my eyes are seeing one such structure in the valley. Thankfully, the military had the decency to build one of their grotesque facilities a few hundred meters away. Apparently, the Pathfinders are seeking a way to get in by gathering artifacts. There was something I could heal. Thought there was. Thought I saw green. It's telling me I need to run up here. I like that. Oh, yeah. Oh, we're gonna have to double jump off that a bit. Oh, there is something green. Hey. We'll heal you up, friend. Here we go. Ready? Get set. Jump. Jump. We made it. I don't know why. This is a lot of fun. I love it. And now there's nothing green down there. Okay. Oh, great.
Given how rarely a life seed is produced, I was so excited when I discovered there was one found in the valley. Apparently, the military was just as excited as they immediately confiscated it to study at the Soma facility on the mountaintop. Oh. They won't let me anywhere near it.
Wow, life seed cradle, organic structure housing embryonic plant. That must be what that is. Okay, so the military has captured our life seed. Let's go see if we can find it. Hey, not happening. We need to jump off that one. Whoop and whoop. No, get there. How about we need to jump off this one? And then we can flutter. We're just using up. Oh, maybe I could just walk up there. Herp a derp a derp. I'm a derp a derp. Okay, now we'll have to run. That was good. Graceful. That. What? I don't like how it's making me jump. Like, I can't see what's in front of me. Here we go. Oh no! Missed it. Stuck on the wall. There we go. And to the Soma facility. Shift to run down a slope for maximum momentum. I do like this. This is good. Oh, 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 yeah! We're going on top. No, we're going on top of the building. On top of the building. We're not going on top of the building. We're trying to get into the building. Okay. Wow, that was really, really awesome. And now we need to explore things, because there's probably loot here. Ooh, something dead. Freedom. Life. Life, little plant machine. We're gonna be the best little plant gathering machine guy ever. Oh no! Never mind. Scratch that. I want your life energy. You're dead. Ho ho! Wow. How do you kill it again? Okay. Beware of the Amatra swarms. They can be pacified with life energy. Damage from their attacks affects your energy count. Damage at zero energy results death. Huh. Okay. So you just need to zap it with life energy. Ooh. This looks fun. Hello. Aw. Really? Is this a spawn point for those stupid things? Or is that a friendly one now? I need to run around. We need loot. There's gotta be loot here. Dead tree. Acorn. Come here. Dead tree. Heal it up. Loot and scoot. Aha, loot box. Under from researcher, the swarms are indigenous to the valley and incredibly aggressive. It is advisable to maintain a considerable distance between oneself and the swarm, otherwise it will send a wave of attack drones toward the victim. Like a bee's defense, the swarms will suicide themselves to protect the rest of the cluster. Or they just shoot you. It's an easier way to say it. So that's where I was before. We were down in that area. I couldn't jump across. I bet I could now with the double jump. Wonder if that'd be advantageous to do, or we can just wait. I've searched around, I haven't found anything else, so I will keep that in mind. Are you healthy yet? Oh, there's something to heal. That was not the thing to heal. Come on, green thing. That doesn't make sense. Oh, it's that tree. Hey, it's a birch tree. Hey, we got quite a bit of energy. That's good news. Jump mode.
There's one thing I could do without in this valley. It's those damn Amrita swarms that seem to infect this place. They aren't so bad when they're calm, but when they're starved of Amrita energy, they become incredibly aggressive, sending waves of drones toward intruders and suicidal attacks. They seem to be becoming angrier the longer we're here.
Made it! Imagine that, they're angrier the longer we're here. Probably because we're sucking up all their energy. Oh yeah, energy boosters. Energy canister increases your suit's capacity by 4 units. Duh. Because it was 4 units. Ooh. Memo, in case of power or shortage, please use the grenades. Oh. Guess what? Generators used by the army have been designated are designed to accept the energy. Try activating one with your suit's juice. Kaboomski! This thing is not gonna work. Okay, detaining questions. Oh good, cutscene, we don't have to go through it all. When a Pathfinder dies while wearing a leaf suit, they are revived at the cost of other nearby living things. This exciting yet dangerous functionality is known as quantum immortality. Okay, quest update to get to the top of the facility. I guess we're still actively going up to the top. And we might have to bump this thing with more juice, I'm guessing. Oh, we didn't get to the top all the way. Oh, yep, there it goes. It's stopped now. Surprise, surprise. Open Donald. Oh, there we go. Thank you. Titan Rock! What's around here?
From what I've been told, the Osiris was discovered back in 1811 by a surveyor seeking to map this remote region. No one believed what he reportedly saw. Due to the sheer remoteness of this region, his story was written off as the senile delusions of an old man, and his tale was soon forgotten. It was not until recently that the government was approached by a scientist named Andrew Fisher to use this location as an alternative energy project of some sort. How he came to discover this place is beyond me.
Did he know about the life seed? From Private Sparks, McDavid's been writing me again. It's like the guy can't take a nap anymore these days. Sure, I was on guard and duty at the time, but what was I guarding against? There's nothing out here. Yesterday I saw a rabbit run by. It was the highlight of my day. So there are going to be nasty critters here. Should we go in this thing? Dead tree.
Hi, squeaky guy. Where, oh, where am I shooting? Go. Oh, wow. The big tree. Do I continue this way? No, I'm supposed to go to the top. So, let's pretend like that didn't happen, and we're gonna go to the top now. So this... Get life, Mr. Tree. How in the world do we get up there? This is a good start. Maybe... jump over here? Not quite. Maybe we do run around. Maybe we run around and up. So I don't see a way to get up there. Well, I guess this is a path of no forgiveness. I'm not going to waste my energy. Oh, yeah. Hello. You're dead. You're dead. That's good. Okay, we're half energy. Oh, boy. Stay on. Oh, stay on. Haha. Some ectoplasm over there. Oh, no. Acorn just dropped. Are we gonna get up that one? Oh, you're kidding me right now. Alright. Oh, we probably could have done just fine. Jump into this one instead. Do we? Should we? No. I'm not gonna jump over there. Oh, yes I am. Oh, yes I am. Uh-huh. Yeah, buddy! Okay, I will gladly use one to get three. Oh, okay, I get it. Oh, get on there! Get on there! Oh, we almost died. We're good, though. I gotta jump again. So, that really wasn't worth it, I don't think. Let's continue on. Yep, we have to climb up around the backside. Hello, ectoplasm. Oh yeah, dodge, duck, dive, dodge. You can dodge a glowy sphere of death. You can dodge your ball. And there's something to turn on. Kaboomski. Tree. Tree of life. Live tree. Oh. Hello. Goop. What do we got? Acorns. You know, I've only fallen to one acorn tree, and now I've got like 20 of them. Gonna jump again. What does this say? Pendulum. Medulla. Okay. Oh, turn you on. No more beacorn trees. Let's grab this. Might be something back here. Nope. Ah. Not gonna leave one of these behind. I might have to start using energy out of the trees. Oh, great. Especially if I do bad jumps like that. Energy low now. Oh, stay on. So where am I? Oh, I'm going this way. Okay. Come on, tree. Ah, we unlocked a door. Good. Energy low. Can't see anything. Ooh. Space balls. We got this guy. Looks like another downed. Oh, oh yes. Are you ready for this? Get to the top. So we have to run down. We're gonna jump. Scratch that. We're gonna collect the rest of these balls because we need them. And then we're gonna go back and we're gonna do the same thing. And we can turn this tree on. Yes, the tree is dead. Let's flip the switch and turn the tree back on. Grab you two. Is there any? Ooh, we might have missed something over here. Or obviously we didn't. This is just a red herring. Let's run to the top of the hill. So we can now run to the bottom of the hill. Wow, all these came back. Okay, that's kind of cool. I didn't realize... Oh boy, where am I going? Ah! Oh no! Oh no! Oh no 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 no! No 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 no! I made it! I made it! Landed! Ow. I'm stuck. Jim. We got problems.
Now I gotta do that all over again. Here goes time three. See if we can just clear it. Oh, so much fun. Yep. That's what it is. We just have to land on the other side over here. Ha! You would think that wearing giant metal shoes would have broken through that chain link fence. No, it's mega chain link fence. Mega rusted old chain link fence that's totally cool yet. Some of facility shack. Ooh! Ha! I've blasted his life. Yo, utility. Okay. What do we have over here? What do we have down here? Anything cool up here? Nope. Anything cool over here? Negative. I don't know what to think about that. We need to crack into that place. We definitely need to crack in. How do we do that? Gotta jump from a high level. Dead tree. No acorns. This is how we jump in. Right here. Geronimo! There's grass inside of this. It's goofy. Huh. Reminder to all personnel, please keep a safe distance away from Amatra swarms. They are aggressive. If a swarm requests a Pathfinder, pacify it. I thought this area was off limits to anyone but Pathfinders. Stay on lookout for intruders on the premise. A number of guards are reported seeing shadowy figures watching our operations from afar. It could be a sign of possible espionage. Report trespassing at once. That's great. From the same people that brought us Slender, we now get shadowy figures. Through the ant. Okay. Explore the elevator shaft. Is that what we're doing now? These lights still have power. Great. Crush Zone! Sounds like some 90s TV show. Nice. Pendulum juice. Aha! Dying while wearing a leaf suit is an incredible experience. No one outside myself can possibly observe it. The best way I can describe it is a daydream someone gets lost in. I die by falling into a lake. The next second I'm standing next to shore. No one else being in the wiser about what just happened to me. Is it even real? I guess that kind of is a goofy experience. What do we have in you? Oh! Grappling hook. Swing yourself to new places with Viper Coil upgrade, allowing Pathfinders to latch onto Deadeye Crane Hooks. Each cost one unit of energy. Oh. Release mid-swing for added boost.
The Viper Coil upgrade to the leaf suit allows Pathfinders to grapple onto certain target points within a limited range, allowing them to reach areas where jumps prove insufficient. For testing purposes, the Viper Coil is currently limited to particular targets.
That's kind of cool. Grapple Man. Oh, okay. Whoosh! So we have to turn him on with energy juice. Oh, that's an acorn tree. Acorn thing. Open it up. Can you imagine exploring a place like this for the first time? Like being a lone explorer, not putting all these things. I have no idea what these different hooks are for. We've got a large portion of this valley mapped so far. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, mappers. As far as I know, we've explored most of the acorn doors. I hear there's a couple squads with almost enough medallions to access that big step pyramid. Wonder how many pyramids that takes. Or how many things it takes. Where am I going now? Up. Yes, sir. Whee! Very nice. Game is pretty intuitive, I gotta say that. Another acorn door here. That's where we start really using them up, isn't it? Okay, note from Virginia King, Samsara. The repeating cycle of birth, life, and death affecting by the karma fostered during one's life is what Pathfinders experience, constantly dying and reviving. According to Buddhism, there is no beginning to this cycle, but it can, however, be broken through enlightenment. It's kind of weird. Mushrooms. Another upgrade. Oh, this is just an energy upgrade. What is this? I feel like I need to break you. Ah! Nope. Is this just a fun room to get more energy? I bet it was. Get the funsies going on. Oopsies. Shwoosh! Oh. Okay, now I pacified him. Hide behind the rock. Some more juice. Good. Oh, there's another one right up there. That's the one we came over on, isn't it? Okay, I need to jump over to that guy, I'm guessing. Where else can I go? Yeah, that's what I gotta do. Aha, I get it now. Get up there! Okay, good. So many acorns. So soon. Wow. Gotcha. So I jumped down there for one acorn, and I ended up using two. Get earth. Okay, got that. Come on up. And now we made it. There's got to be something back here. Up here? No. Ooh. Thought that was green. It's like a trap. I'm not going to walk on that. And then that's our jumping platform. Hello, crazy bugs. And go! Landed it. Excellent, we made it to the top now. Or what should have been the top. Is that? Nope. Energy upgrade? How many do we got? That's three? Heh. Oh, great. I almost missed this. Note from Engineer. Ever since the Pathfinder program decided to use the Deadeye Crane blocks as part of their training, my engineers have been constantly putting themselves in harm's way to set them up. One poor fellow tragically fell to his death while stringing up a Deadeye across the chasm. We don't ever wear the L.E.A.F suit, otherwise he may have lived. What a waste. There's nothing else in there. Do we go up? Or do we go down? Explore the elevator shaft. Alright. Oh yeah. Imagine that. Energy. I guess this is going to go back up now. Soma loading bay. It's up, up, and away. So is this elevator shaft going to break down again? Or is it going to stop? Is this where we came in at? Yep, that's where we first fell down at. So I'm guessing it's going to stop somewhere pretty close. Like right here? Where am I going to get out at? Ah, there we go. Ooh. Quest updated. Continue journey to reach mountaintop facility. Alright, we gotta turn this guy on. And now we launch ourselves across. Uh-oh. I gotta double jump. Get over there! Get over there! Get over there! You're kidding me! Okay, gotta go halfway. And then we release yourself. Oh, I'm gonna do it again! Ah, made it. Made it this time. Good. I'll tell you what, guys. I think that's going to be a good spot to cut off this first episode. I know... Ooh, Pathfinder training area. Post-headquarters, post-exchange. Thank you for watching the last hour or so with me. I'm not sure how long, so I'm going to edit some of it out. The boring times. It might have been all boring. I don't know, but if you're continuing watching this an hour in, I don't know why you'd consider it all boring. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed. Stay tuned for much more of this. And keep your stick on the ice. We'll catch you next time.